Hello everyone, this is Dr. Kalpana and you are watching this video on my YouTube channel Pharmacy Lessons Made Easy. It is well known fact that the very basic part of pharmaceutical calculation is allegation. Today in this lecture we shall learn the methodology of performing pharmaceutical allegation. So let's begin today's topic. The topic is use of allegation method in dispensing pharmacy. Now, the importance of allegation method. It is used to calculate the requirement of ingredients as per the official formula and conversion of the required quantity. This is very important and useful in pharmaceutical calculations. Mixed allegation method, also known as alternative allegation method, can also be utilized and employed if more than two solutions have to be mixed to get the required concentration. Now, the allegation. Allegation as such literally means the calculation of relative amounts of ingredients of different percentage strength to make the product of required strength. And as far as allegation method is concerned, it is the calculation of the mixture of ingredients possessing different percentage strengths using the weighed average of the mixture and given the quantity and the concentrations. Now, may I have your attention on this, that how to perform or how to do this allegation part, right? Let's take an example to understand the concept of this allegation. As an example, I have 34% and 21% solution of aqueous glycerol solution and I have to get 50 ml of 29% solution from it. The question is how much volume of each solutions must be mixed so that the final concentration reached is 29%. Now, how to perform the experiment or the allegation actually is, you have to do, just take care of what you have and what to get from it. Like in this current example, we have 34% glycerol solution and 21% glycerol solution and we have to get 29% glycerol solution whose volume is 50 ml out of it. Now we shall calculate the proportion in which these two glycerol solutions should be mixed so as to get the required quantity, correct? So, by placing them on the left hand side of what you have, the different mixtures, and what you want to get should be kept in the center part of it, then diagonally make the difference of the two numeric figures, I mean 34 and 29 in one case, and diagonally if you move, then the difference comes out to be 5 and that has to be written at the bottom of it. The same way, 21% and 29%, if you take the difference, it comes out to be 8, and this 8 you have to write at the upper right part, right? So the arrangement will look like that, will as shown here in the figure. So that the proportion that we got is 8 parts of 34% glycerol solution and 5 parts of 21% glycerol solution. If we add these two fractions, that comes out to be 13 parts, 8 parts plus 5 parts. So the next step of it is the calculation for 50 ml of 29% glycerol solution. So we got the fraction till now, that out of 13 parts of the total solution, right, we have to take 8 parts from 34% glycerol solution and we have to take 5 parts from 21% glycerol solution, right? So the volume of 34% glycerol required, how much is the exact volume that is required? We were talking in terms of parts earlier. Now we have to get the exact quantity calculation. For that exact quantity calculation, we have to apply the formula. That is, the volume of 34% glycerol required is equal to how much fraction of that glycerol solution divided by the total parts of the solution, which are to be distributed among the two parts, multiplied by the required volume. So, placing the values in this formula, we shall get 8 out of 13, that is 8 divided by 13 multiplied by 50, that comes out to be 30.761 ml. The same way, if we apply the same calculation for the volume of 21% glycerol solution required, that comes out to be 5 parts out of 13 parts, that means 5 divided by 13 multiplied by the required volume, that is 50 ml. It comes out to be 19.230 ml, right? So, if I want to check whether I have calculated it correctly or not, I have to sum up the total volume that I got after the calculations, right? So, the two volumes that I got after calculations are 30.769 ml and 19.230 ml. If I add on these two quantities, what I'll get? It is 49.999 ml, which is approximately equal to 50 ml. That means whatever I have calculated is correct. So, what is the check that if I have done a slight mistake, then how it will look like? Just take the example. What if the calculation is not done correctly, right? So, we had 34% glycerol solution and 21% glycerol solution as per the problem, and we have to reach up to 29% glycerol solution, 50 ml. So, if I apply the same methodology, that is taking the difference and placing it diagonally opposite, I have put 5 at the bottom right path and 29 is difference, that is 8 path, I have put it on the top right part. So, if I have done a mistake, suppose in this case 8 plus 5, despite of writing it as 13, I have taken it as 14. I mean, intentionally I have done a mistake, but if some mistake is there, then how I can come to know that I have committed a mistake? So, the check is for 50 ml of 29% glycerol solution, as per our calculation, the volume of 34% glycerol required, applying the same formula, that is number of parts of that particular solution divided by the total number of parts multiplied by the volume required, right? So, in this case, it is 8 divided by 14. 14 is a wrong figure, right? It should ideally be 13, but we have... what if we have done a mistake, right? So, 8 out of 14, that is 8 by 14 multiplied by 50, that comes out to be 28.571 ml. The same way, if we do the calculation for the volume of 21% glycerol required, it is 5 divided by 14 into 50, which comes out to be 17.857 ml. So, the check that I have told you in the previous case, that we have to sum up the two values. So, if I sum up 28.571 plus 17.857, the figure that I got is 46.428 ml. That is not the required quantity. The required quantity was 50 ml. So, it is not equal to 50 ml. That means whatever calculation we have done are not correct. So, friends, hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. For more interesting and informative videos on pharmacy, do like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And also, don't forget to share this video. Thank you very much.